Hi, I'm Barbara, the co-CEO of 100% Renewables, a consultancy specializing in the development of climate action strategies. In my last video, I talked about the meaning of the terms carbon neutral, net zero, and climate neutral. In summary, a carbon neutral target relates to carbon dioxide only, whereas a net zero goal includes all greenhouse gases. And a climate neutral goal extends to other effects such as radiative forcing as well. When thinking of greenhouse gases, most people would list carbon dioxide as the main culprit, and it is indeed the most prevalent greenhouse gas. But according to the Greenhouse Gas Protocol, there are seven greenhouse gases that you need to report on. The first is carbon dioxide, CO2, which is mostly emitted by burning fossil fuels. Second is methane, CH4, which is mostly emitted by growing ruminant animals such as sheep and cows, and it also comes from landfills. Third one is nitrous oxide, N2O, which is mostly emitted by growing crops through fertilizer usage and by growing livestock through manure. The fourth is hydrofluorocarbons, HFCs, which are mostly emitted by refrigeration equipment. The fifth one is perfluorocarbons, PFCs, which are mostly emitted by the aluminium industry. The sixth one is sulfur hexafluoride, SF6, which is mostly emitted by switchgear. The newest addition is nitrogen trifluoride, NF3, which is mostly emitted in computer manufacturing. Carbon dioxide is the most important greenhouse gas due to the vast quantities that are being emitted and due to its long life. It can live for hundreds of years in the atmosphere. Another such long-lived greenhouse gas is nitrous oxide at more than 100 years. Methane, for instance, exists in the atmosphere for a much shorter period, but has a much higher global warming potential than CO2. Meaning that this gas causes more global warming per ton than CO2. Most fluorinated gases like PFCs, SF6, HFCs have very high global warming potentials, so small atmospheric concentrations can have disproportionately large effects on global temperatures. They can also last in the atmosphere for thousands of years. And whereas carbon dioxide can be absorbed by growing plants, no living organism needs HFCs in any of their processes. Most organizations are emitting carbon dioxide as their most significant greenhouse gas. In my next video, I'll talk about how you can reach carbon neutrality or net zero emissions. Thanks for watching.